A hair appointment in Hickory Hill takes a dangerous turn. Thanks for joining us. I'm Shay Arthur, in for Alex and April tonight. One person is in the hospital, another facing charges following a shooting at the Park Apartments. WREG's Melissa Moon tells us what happened.
This broken window and a piece of crime scene tape are the only signs something happened at this apartment complex Wednesday afternoon.
We heard a lot of racket noise. I mean, exactly how it happened, I don't know.
Police say Kerlea Javon spent most of the day inside her apartment braiding another woman's hair when the two women got into a fight. They say Javon refused to let the woman back into her apartment to get her belongings, and the woman broke out the window. Investigators say that's when Javon tried to pull the woman through the window, and she told her sister's boyfriend to go get a gun and shoot her.
We were just sitting in the house talking like we usually do. We just heard a lot of loud noise, bang, bang, bang.
Police say the sister's boyfriend fired several shots at the woman as she was getting into a car, but hit another woman in the passenger seat in the back. A third woman in the rear of the vehicle was not hurt.
A lot of mishaps for no reason at all.
Jerome Parker lives in a building nearby. He says he and his fiance had been planning to leave Memphis because of the crime.
It's bad. It's too bad.
Parker says they want to move to someplace quiet in the country, and after yesterday's shooting, he's ready to go.
Everybody just have to take care of themselves. I don't bother nobody, disrespect no one. Everybody else should do the same.
In Hickory Hill, Melissa Moon, WREG, News Channel 3.
Now, that victim who was shot in the back was taken to the hospital. They're expected to be okay. The woman who broke out the window was treated for an injury to her hand. At last check, the person police say pulled the trigger has not been charged. Officers have not said if he's a minor.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Kol Olam La. Albanawa Yahawa Bahashim Yahawah Shai Bahashim Rechach Radash. Double honors to the elder apostles and elder bishops of Great Millstone who rule well. Salutations to the Achaim out there on the highways and the byways. Salutations to the hopeful elect. Salutations to you speckled birds, you Israelite foreigners. And shalom to the Akwaf sitting and listening in silence as the scriptures say to do so. Okay, this is your brother Amoth Yahais from Yahawada. Back at it again with another beautiful lesson and message to the power and spirit of Yahawah, Bahashim, Yahawah Shai. And as you saw in the video clip, man, you know, Eve out here being buck wild, man. Okay, over a hairdo, man, you know, a hair appointment gone wrong, man. Okay, look, man, I don't know what the argument was about, the fussing and the fight, man. But look, man, if you kicked that woman out your house, man, you could at least gave her stuff, man. You didn't have to let her come back in to the crib. You could have grabbed the stuff and just handed it to her at the door, man. Point blank, period, man. Okay? You got to use wisdom, man, to avoid conflict, man. Okay? But, you know, this is our people, man. Our people are brute beasts, man. Our people are savages, man. Why do you think Megan Thee Stallion made that song, I'm a Savage? These bitches are savages, man. Okay? And these niggas are animals, man. Period, man. And I call it how I see it, man. Okay? Like I always say, and like every other brother says, man, 2/3 of our people are heathens, man. So, man, let's let the Bible talk, man. Let's go to Ecclesiasticus, also known as Sirach. Chapter 9. I believe that's what I want. Chapter 9. No, this is not what I want. I'm trying to think. This is chapter 8, Salaki. I'm in the wrong chapter. Forgive me. Okay, Ecclesiasticus, also known as Sirach, chapter 9. Salaki, you know what? Forgive me. It's chapter 6. Forgive me. All right, Ecclesiasticus, chapter 6, verse 8, and it reads this. For some man is a friend for his own occasion, and will not abide in the day of trouble. So look, man, a lot of our people are users, man. A lot of our people will be your friend for their benefits, man. And from what I'm seeing that's being broadcast, obviously this woman was this other woman's friend just to get her hair done, man. Because when all hell broke loose, you know, she was she broke her window, trying to pull her out the window. And then, you know, other stuff occurred, man. Okay? For some man is a friend for his own occasion. You should be testing your friends, man, to see if they really your friends, man. Because they could only be around for prosperity, man. Okay, when it comes time for adversity, They gonna act like they don't know you, man. For some man is a friend for his own occasion and will not abide in the day of trouble. And that's right, man. So when that day of trouble come, man, who? Amoth who? I don't know that dude. Christina who? I don't know her. I'm telling you, man. Jake will befriend you. Eve will befriend you for their own benefits, man. That's why you're always supposed to examine these people, man, that you call your friends, man. Because at the end of the day, you'll find out the hard way that they're not your friends, man. Okay? Period. But let's keep on going. Let's go to 2 Peter, man, because I made a statement. Let me go ahead and read that. 2 Peter chapter 2. I think that's verse 12 that I want. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 12. But these are natural brute beasts. Natural brute beasts, man. From the end of woman to you wicked Jakes, man. Y'all are brute beasts, man. Okay? Don't know how to just talk, resolve your conflicts, your issues, your problems with your people, man. But the first thing you do is try to resolve things with violence, man. Okay? And that also falls back with y'all cleaving on to the ways of Esau Edom, man. Because Esau Edom is a violent man. He's a bloodshedder, a murderer, man. So y'all follow his customs, man. Okay? And that's why he's your daddy, man. Okay? 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 12. But these are natural brute beasts made to be taken and destroyed. And that's going to be the end game for two-thirds of our people, man. You're going to be taken and destroyed, man. Yahweh Hashem Yahushua is going to turn this cave monkey up and let him have his way with you, man. His last hoorah, man. Okay? To appease the wrath and the anger of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. Yahweh Hashem Yahushua is going to put his righteous indignation on these Edomites and these other heathens to take you Jakes out, man. Okay? Judgment. Okay? As Elder Apostle Tahar coined this year, the year of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, turn it up. And it already started off at a good start, man. Okay? But these are natural brute beasts made to be taken and destroyed, speak evil of the things that they understand not, man. And these N-dubs and these Jakes, man, always talking down on things they don't understand, man. Especially this truth, man. And furthermore, Yahweh Hashem Yahushua didn't enlighten them. He didn't wake them up. He chose to keep these people asleep, the ones that scoff, mock, do all that, man. Okay, talking about there's no Yahusha is an idol, okay, and amongst other things too, man. Amongst a lot of vomit doctrine, man. Speak evil of the things they understand not, and shall utterly, okay, and shall for certain shall utterly perish in their own corruption, man. Okay, you're gonna perish, man. Okay, two-thirds of you heathen Jakes, man, are gonna perish, man. Okay, you got people out here fighting over a damn hairdo, man. And like I said, man, whatever was said, man, you could have easily figured out the problem, man. As it says in Proverbs 15:1, a soft answer turn away wrath, man. So it's no need to buck up against every situation, man. Use knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, man, before you speak, man. Okay? Because that might save your life, man. Let's keep on going, man. But you know, our people are emotional, man. Okay, not just the woman. We know the woman go off emotion more than logic, but you men are highly emotional too, man. Okay, you estrogen based beta male simps, man. Okay? These daggone women got more cojones than you do, man. Cause the roles have been reversed, man. Okay, there's no structure in the household, man. Let's jump back to Sirach real quick. Ecclesiasticus, also known as Sirach, chapter 7. And I'm going to read verses 16 to 17. I believe that's what I want. Like I said, man, Sirach 7, verse 16 to 17. And it reads this. Number not thyself among the multitude of sinners. So you shouldn't be in cahoots or be affiliated with sinners, man. Because there's an old saying, you are who you hang out with, man. Okay, so that's who you is, man. But the hopeful elect, which we hope and pray to be the elect, we're not going to be mingled amongst sinners, man. And that's not to say that we haven't sinned and that we don't sin. Because this flesh is corruptible, man. This flesh is weak, man. But the difference between us and you, the difference between us and them, is that we acknowledge that we need that physician. We acknowledge that we need healing. We acknowledge that we need salvation, saving, man. And we attempt every single second of the day to walk righteously, man. But nah, not the other Jakes, not the other Eves, man. Number not thyself among the multitude of sinners, but remember that wrath will not tarry long. That's right, man. That punishment is right around the corner, man. Okay, Yahabah Hashem Yahushua is done sitting back, letting all this madness happen before his eyes, man. He's done seeing all this unrighteousness, this wickedness, this filth dwelling amongst his people, man. So you got to be corrected. And how are you going to be corrected? There's two ways. Either he's going to wake you up to the truth, or he's going to judge you, man. Period, man. Verse 17, humble. So these both of these women, man, should have humbled themselves, man. But nah, emotions get in the mix, and our people go off emotions, man. Quick, in the blink of an eye, in the flick of a wrist, our people are highly elevated off their emotions, man. Humble thyself greatly. You got to be humble. You have some humility about yourself, man. Humble thyself greatly, for the vengeance of the ungodly is fire and worms, man. Look, the ungodly will do anything, especially our people, man. When that hatred sparks up against our own people, man, look, man, all we're thinking about is a bloodshed. And what is the first thing Jake say? All I saw was black. All I saw was red. Attempting to cause harm to your own people, to put your own people to death, man. You should not be putting your hands on your people, man. Always talk out the matter, man. Because at the end of the day, if this was Esau, I'm sorry, sir. Excuse me, master. You wouldn't say nothing. You would just take it. But from your own people, you want to attempt to take their life. Instead of just saying, hey, you know what? It's a better way to resolve this situation. Let me take a couple of breaths and let me have an adult conversation with this person. But nah, you want to lay hands on your brother or your sister, man. So this is 1 Timothy chapter 5. Okay, and this scripture has another meaning into it, and I'm going to break that down, but I'm also break it down while I'm using it this way. All right, so this is 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 22. Lay hands suddenly on no man. So when it says lay hands suddenly on no man, it's talking about uplifting the man, giving the man a certain position, embracing that man, establishing that man. Okay, saying he's ready to be in the camp. He's ready for this position. He's ready for that. Okay. That's what this scripture is stating on the correct matter. Lay hands suddenly on no man. Don't exalt that man. Examine that man thoroughly. Okay, but in this video, in this aspect, I'm saying lay hands suddenly on no man. So these women are wrong. Okay, both of them are wrong. And you shouldn't be laying hands on each other, period. Lay hands suddenly on no man, neither be partaker of other men's sins. So you don't want to exalt a man, and then when he messed up, he sin, he go off, it's going to reflect on you too, because you didn't thoroughly examine that person. And you don't want to lay hands on somebody in the physical aspect of out of rage and emotion. Keep yourself pure, as it's going to say, man. Keep thyself pure, man. Let the Most High get that vengeance. Let the Most High, Yahweh Baal Shem Yahushua, be the judge, man. Hey, come on, man. Look, man, do you not think we don't want to put hands on our people first and foremost? And especially on Esau and these heathens, do you not think we don't want to? Nah, man. There's a time for everything. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 on down. There's a time for everything. And right now is not the time. We're supposed to just preach and teach the gospel. Okay? We're going to have our time, man. Yahweh Hashem Yahushua is going to let us have our time, man. But we got to wait on the Lord, man. Period. Now let's keep on going. Let's jump back to Sirach real quick. Ecclesiastes, also known as Sirach, chapter 12. And let's read verse 8. A friend cannot be known in prosperity. Now, what does that word prosperity mean? Let's look up that word prosperity. Prosperity. Already got it pulled up. Prosperity. The condition of being successful or thriving, especially. The condition of being successful or thriving, especially. Now let's go to the Merriam-Webster.
Prosperity.
All right, prosperity, it says the state of being successful, usually by making a lot of money. Okay, so let's jump back. So Rock 12, verse 8 again. A friend cannot be known in prosperity, and an enemy cannot be hid in adversity, man. So look, man, like I said before, man, you ain't going to be able, you should be examining your friends from the jump, man, before you even consider them friends. Okay? Matter of fact, they should just be associates until they prove themselves, man. Period. Okay, because they'll put on this big show, this big act, if you have a lot of prosperity, man. If you're successful, if you thrive in everything you do, oh, man, oh, that person shines. I want to be their friend. They can benefit me in some type of way, some type of avenue of my life, man. But when it comes to adversity, it could be them bringing the adversity and really speaking that truth. Oh, I ain't like you anyway. I was never your friend for this and such, blah, 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 this, that reason and this reason. Then you find out the truth the hard way. Because you didn't prove that person first. You welcomed them with open arms, man. You didn't test their spirit. You didn't examine them. You didn't do nothing. You just believed. Okay? But let's keep on going. Let's go to St. James. St. James chapter 5, verse 9. And it reads this. Grudge not one against another, brethren. So look, man, these women were grudging against each other in this video, man, over a hair appointment, man. Whatever the case may be, man. Okay? Grudge not one against another, brethren. Lest ye be condemned, behold, the judge standeth before the door. And look, man, Yahabashim Yahushua brought judgment quick on this, man. Now, you know, nobody's life was taken, but this was a warning. This was a pure warning, man. The beginning of mournings, okay? The beginning of affliction, of sufferings. Because somebody still got shot and had to go to the hospital and get medical attention. And the woman that broke the glass and tried to pull the woman out, she had to get medical attention too, man. Okay? So grudge not one against another, man. Okay? Get out that unrighteous spirit, man. Period, man. But let's close out here, man. Let's close out here. This is Ecclesiasticus, also known as Sirach, chapter 37. I'm going to read verses 2 to 4. Is it not a grief unto death when a companion and friend is turned to an enemy? It is, man, because they know everything about you. They know where you live, probably where you work, your family, your kids. They know everything about you, man, your secrets. What you like, what you don't like. Okay? You don't want your friend to become your enemy, man. That's one of the worst type of enemies you can have, man. Is it not a grief unto death when a companion and friend is turned to an enemy? O wicked imagination, whence comest thou into cover the earth with deceit? There is a companion which rejoiceth in the prosperity of a friend, but in the time of trouble will be against him, man. And what you heard about this story is a prime example of that, man. Whatever the issue was, whatever was brought forth to start this argument and this warning that Yahweh Hashem Yahushua sent upon them, man. I don't know what it was, but I'm gonna tell you like this: more than likely, 144% more than likely, it could have been resolved just by having a cool, calm, collect conversation, man. But our people are emotional, effeminate, weak, and carnal. So we're going to leave it right there, man. Lord willing, I hope and I pray that this was edifying and uplifting to the hopeful elect. So with that, as always, I'm just going to say, Shalom.